Hi, today we're finishing 3 Nancy Clancy Book 3, Chapter 12, Out of Business. The next morning, Nancy and Bree meet up at the corner. Bree was wearing sunglasses to protect her black eye and looked très glamorous. Nancy had a bunch of envelopes in her backpack with the money she was giving back, as well as a perfect exhaust. She had written a note that said, "It has come to my attention that no one is permitted to make money on school property. So I'm returning your money. I have also decided to quit the fortune-telling business for good. Yours truly, Nancy Clancy." "You work along," Nancy admitted to Bree as they walked to school. "I never had powers. Nobody does. All the stuff that they thought was seeing the future was only good guessing." Bree stopped on the sidewalk. "Okay, I have to admit sometimes something to you do too." Bree scrunched up her face. "I didn't want you to have powers. I was jealous you had something special that I didn't." "So you believed in my powers?" "A little, I wasn't sure. It also made you too different from me. That made me feel funny. I like us both, just behind regular girls." "Yes," Nancy could understand that. "My fortune-telling ensemble sure was lovely. I wish you hadn't seen it. I wore a long, ruffy skirt of Mrs. DeVries in a shawl and these big clip and gold earrings." At school, Mr. Dudley asked everyone to wait outside the classroom for a minute. "Clara is almost done taking the spelling test that she missed." When the door opened again, Clara was hopping around her desk going a little victory dance. "I nailed it." She came over and hugged Nancy. "I remember even hearing." She lowered her voice and peering. "My mom says that seeing the future is crazy. But that you're right about having a positive attitude." Nancy decided to hand out the envelopes at recess. Grace was busy jumping rope. "Double Dutch," the girls from one of the other third grade classes. First, Nancy went up to Joel. Joel was kneeling in the dirt. 8, 7, 6, he counted. Down, Nancy waited for his Lego spaceship to blast off. "Joel, I have something for you." Joel wasn't paying attention. "This is mission control. The third stage rockets have fired. You are leaving Earth's atmosphere." Nancy was about to leave the envelope on the ground, where she'd be sure to see it. Then something really weird happened. Nancy's hands tore open the envelope and took out the cartridge. Her finger tapped Joel on the back. And when she spun around, she held out the cartridge. "I shouldn't have taken money from you. I can see the future." Joel looked irritated at being interrupted. "I never really thought you could." He pocketed the cartridge. Then he went back to zooming his spaceship around and around. Nancy told the truth to everybody. It turned out to not be a big deal. Lynn was the most disappointed. "You're Kara was just getting started. As soon as she got home, Nancy told her mother about returning the money. Nobody was mad. And Grace doesn't even know. I had this great exhaust made up. But something stopped me from fibbing. Mom, I was like this invisible force came out of nowhere and took possession of me. It forced me to tell the truth." Her mom smiled and kissed the top of Nancy's head. I know about that kind of invisible force. It's called coincidence. Bye.